Hi guys, how are you? We are finally live, broadcasting live from GK Fitness Studio at Irving Park in Austin. And with me today in the studio is Polish Mama Lester Zury.
Uncensored.
Uncensored. And then Polish biker, Ted Milówka, the president of Soku Riders, Polish Motorcycle Club. And then Marta Dąbrowski. President of Success Kurt, and then me. So me, I am Dizzy IGA. Okay, guys. I'm really sorry we have delay, but we have new equipment and everything is set up by Polish Tata. Adam Romanowski.
You can share it now.
Okay, guys. So first of all, I want to make sure that we're gonna be visible and everybody can hear us. So if someone can say something. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this is the envelope for everyone.
Okay.
So you can now open the envelope, and those are the questions of today. Okay. So, we're going to choose some questions, but first of all, I want to know something about you. So, Kinga, Ted, Marta, you have to introduce yourselves and tell me about your passion.
As you said, I'm the president of Polish Motorcycle Association and Soku Riders. And speaking of passion, so obviously my passion is riding a motorcycle.
Yes.
But besides this, I give many other passions. For instance, I got loved by horses, and I doing horseback riding. And as a matter of fact, I just came back from this base table where I had a friend of mine who was having a lesson today, and I even gave her some instructions. So that's my another passion. I love skiing, that's true.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That's a lot of things I'm doing around. But basically, the motorcycle is my biggest and the craziest.
And then you are leading Soku Riders for 5 years?
6 years. This year we get 6th anniversary under Soku Riders, new name, Soku Riders. And altogether we've been, 21 years in the business? Business that you started, Jika. And last year we had such a great year because we had our 20th anniversary going on. So it's quite a while.
Lucky, I have to tell you something. I forgot to tell you this at the beginning. I want to apologize for me not showing up for this anniversary. It's my fault. Next day, I had a GK Fitness Marathon. I was at bed probably around 7 o'clock, sleeping, and I didn't wake up. I know I promised I'm going to be there, and I couldn't come. I'm sorry.
Yeah, we never started our party that early. Yeah.
About 15 women that they started businesses
money, resources, and lobbies, so I would say that would I help the other companies to stay afloat.
Very nice. Kinga, now I want you to introduce yourself. I don't know, can people hear us or no?
Przerywa i słabo słychać.
It's a first.
It's first
edition.
Broadcasting live. Everything is disconnected.
I'm sure
so.
It will be much better next time.
Yes.
Yeah, and
stop hating. Support.
Support. It's about the good energy. So my name is Kinga Romanowski, and
Polish blogger and YouTuber.
And I'm a Polish mama, bez cenzury, which means uncensored, and it's not about swearing or some uncensored stuff. It's most of the time about not being ready, and but going live anyway and tell you stuff, what I'm doing, and I'm a mom, and I think I'm trying to motivate moms to get up in the morning, to go to the store, and not worry about the freaking makeup, because we all beautiful, we all we are moms, we are people who are busy in life, so we don't have time to look super awesome enough to look awesome, I guess.
We are awesome anyway.
So.
Okay.
Mascara doesn't make any difference at that.
So I have three of you here today, the first time doing this live with our broken English, so our American friends can understand us. So I want to ask if you are, if you're going to risk any of the answers to any of the questions that I ask you. You've never seen those questions before, you just see them now. So is there any question that you are willing to start, answer, to say something about? There are some
guns.
Guns, okay.
And roses.
Do you have any resolution for the situation?
Resolution? I don't think I have resolution. Well, I think we first, what we have supposed to do is to learn about guns, how they work, not to be afraid of guns, and know how to use it, and then hide them very well from kids and supervise them. I think that's the main thing, and because gun doesn't kill people. I'm sorry.
So what do you think?
I think that now there is a lot of talks of controlling the guns and accessibility of guns to people. But what you said, guns don't kill people, people kill people. So if we stop having guns or stop access to guns, it's not really good, because our freedom is at stake. This is the amendment to the Constitution of the United States, that every citizen is should have a gun to his or her safety. Yeah. And when we take guns away from people, that doesn't mean that those people who want to use those guns and commit crimes, they're not going to be able to. I mean, they will get the guns otherwise. And usually people who own guns legally, it's very seldom when they commit crimes with those guns. Most crimes, I think, are committed by those who own guns illegally.
Yeah.
That's what I think.
Yeah. Okay.
So
cool.
Taking guns away, it's not an answer.
It's not going to
resolve
any issues.
Not gonna resolve.
What do you think?
What I'm saying is I would say that the taking away the right to own the gun is not going to resolve the issues. It's going to, I'd rather screen the people that they apply for it. And as we know, the guy who committed that crime in part-time Florida, he owned legally a couple pieces of it. And what it's really scary thing is that in the time frame of 3 months before that tragedy happened, it was 39 times police and their house. So it's something wrong there. I think that where we, it was lack of the commitment from the security,
well,
of the
people,
police,
yeah.
And the other people who were aware of the situation, the mental situation with that boy. So I think that the victims, it's not only the people who got shot and died, but also the people who were like aware of the situation, and now they
so I
it's same thing with kids, like, you know, if accident happens, so the kid's gonna pull the gun, if you not put it away in a safe place, same thing with knives, same thing with Tide Pods, I mean, they're gonna eat the freaking Tide Pods, because they're curious, and this is what's gonna happen. So I think it's our responsibility as a parent to teach kids about guns. I mean, accidents happen.
Yeah, I'm gonna challenge you guys by saying something else. How come in the United States you cannot drink alcohol over 21, but you can buy a gun by 18?
I think that we are not the ones that they
what?
Not everywhere.
Okay.
That breaks down to states. So we got Capitol Hill and everything else, like Wisconsin.
We have Polish Tata here behind you.
So in Wisconsin, I just want to say something behind the camera about the guns.
Okay.
Gun safe. My daughter, she's 2.5, they can hear me, 2.5. And she knows the difference between the pistol, rifle, and the shotgun. And if I ask her, can you touch it? No. Why? It's daddy stuff.
Okay.
So that's 2.5 years old. But alcohol, Wisconsin, you can bring a child when it's 17 years old, to the bar and drink with him because you're our parent and you attend with them, you give them the permission. So that's very on states.
But I also heard about all those guys that killed other people, that they did not have a role model as a father, like they didn't have fathers.
Yeah, so this is the majority of parent failed parenting.
Uh-huh.
You know, sometimes splitting a marriage isn't it, in fact.
Okay. Anything else, guys? Do you want to add or change the subject? Okay, Marta. I want to see. That's important because I want to know the view of the male point of view in this situation.
I mean, from my perspective, is that the sexuality is the time is up, and Me Too, it doesn't apply only to women.
Okay,
this is the first and foremost, and let's everybody remember the Bill Cosby, right? Why the people were waiting? Like, why the women were waiting 50 years and 40 years to step up and say something? It's just ridiculous. And what does it give them the right to do so? Wait, and now it's the situation with the Bernstein or whatever his name is, that it's actually now the women are stepping up after years of abuse or whatever it was. I do understand that some of those cases are real and some of those cases were really tragic, and it shouldn't be like that. But actually, we set up the borders when it comes to women. It's we who set up the boundaries.
Yes.
It's us who set up the fine line. And it's up to us who's going to do it. That is my
opinion.
Okay. Don't you think that this is what's going on now with all those lawsuits and everything kind of going out of hands?
Yeah,
now,
it's money.
I understand what you said, that there was real things that were happening, and there are real things that should be punished or whatever should be brought to light. But now there is like the left and right when you look, there was some kind of accusation against men because I don't know, look bad at somebody or did something or whatever. It's kind of like witch hunt.
It's definitely something up there, and I would
say
mostly in the groups that it's a lot of money involved and the families and celebrity kind of stuff. So of course this is money involved, right? But when we think about the abuse in a workplace, like a regular woman, like a regular man, and you could see it everywhere in every place. So my question now, it will be, how many regular people will step up and do something about it where it's no money involved, no families is involved, and no celebrity life is involved? That is the question what we should ask. When is the time's up to actually cherish our body, cherish the body of someone else, and the people who are entitled to actually be in state of mind that they could take, have a decision of their own versus that someone else make it for them. And that will be also the sexual abuse of the underage kids, and it will be the predators and stuff like that. It's not only the woman or men, adult, when it comes to the adulthood, it also comes to the kids. That is like what I would like to say.
Well, my point of view is, you And because people were like afraid of something to come out of the closet and say, hey, I was abused or something. But I think that all those things going on publicly, like people calling, people are named abusers and sexual harassments and all that stuff, I think that scares people from telling the truth. Let's say, okay, I'm watching your TV and I'm looking at someone being accused of sexual harassment, and there is the lady or a guy or a girl or a boy, and then I see all the drama they're going through, and I'm like, I don't really want to go through it. I think this is my personal stuff, my personal tragedy, what happened, somebody touched me or I don't know, hit me or whatever. And I don't think I want to make that big of this. I want to punish the guy or the person who hurt me, but do I want to be publicly? Because
it will be much more punishment there.
I'm not talking Hollywood. I'm talking even like right now. There's a lady. She's being accused. I mean, that's good that it's out there because she's a bad person and whatever. It's cool. But do I really, as a kid, or as a teenager, or as a woman, do I want to be like a WJ news or somewhere? Being mean, like, oh, I was abused. I don't want people to know. This is my stuff. I'm going to punish the guy or the girl or whatever. But I don't want to be there. I don't want to be there. Oh, she was abused. I don't want to be there.
But you know what? I think it's the society that set up the frames for that. And I can tell it from my perspective. I was working as a volunteer for 7 years in the shelter for abused women and kids. And I think I've seen it all. The one thing that the woman over there have to work with, it was the acknowledgement that they were abused, because they, as a victim, they haven't had that acknowledgement
yeah.
that they were abused. And then it's exactly what you are saying, that they don't want to have that stigmata that I was abused, because in our society, and I'm talking about the Polish community society, the thing that the church actually set up the frames for something, and I'm talking about the unmarried woman having kids, it's still a huge stigmata, even though that we live in the 21st century, or unmarried woman having a boyfriend and stuff like that. So that what it's also making the point for the things you were saying, that they don't want to be, actually, for the stepping up and say something, that they were, I'm sorry, that something happened to them, it put them in the risk that they will have that, the stigmata that they allowed it, and why did it happen, and that what they, you know, that what they're going through.
The knowledge about what's abuse, yes, I think we have a lack of it. And at work, you will think, oh, this, my boss said something nice, or he touched my shoulder, or whatever. I don't know if it's good or bad. I don't know what to do. Some people don't think. Some people were not raised that way. That at home, many times you're crossing the boundaries. And you know how it is. I'm married, okay, and my husband goes by me, and he's gonna like smack my butt. He will do it. It's my husband.
Not true.
My kid is watching
it. Yeah, and it will be the question if that behavior is correct or not.
And then I have to, I'm not responsible for that, whether my kid knows that this is my husband and her dad, and this is okay, and it was not hard, and this is, but it's not okay for somebody else to do this.
Stranger, right?
And I'm not blaming anybody. It just, we don't think about it because we think stuff like this not going to happen to us. Maybe,
and it doesn't apply to us, right?
Yes.
But I tell you something, in small village, and I'm from small village, Kalinova, it was normal for us to go into the bus, and there was guys that were touching girls. It was
and
like
it was normal?
And it was nothing, like, there was no word abuse. It was
back then,
even back then, it was like, oh my God, I'm going to that bus, and I hate this shit. It was like, you're going through that shit, it's like,
it's normal, like a daily routine.
Yeah, so you got hurt. Yeah, like you got hurt that nothing like this matters anymore. I don't stand up for myself now, but when I was younger, there was no word abuse. We did not know it.
That's true. But you didn't like the thing.
It's like, well,
you said
the guy has the power to do it.
But the mom tells you, you said you don't like the medicine, you drink it.
Right, but you said that you didn't like it, and you didn't like the fact that you had to go to that bus,
right?
Right.
Bus.
But you didn't know what to do, or you didn't realize that that was abused. But that wasn't like normal to you, was it?
No. We all knew who was like predator, like who was crazy, who was like, we all knew in the small village.
Everybody knows.
What do you think? It's okay now, like say that happened 25 years ago, something. So now it's okay, like I would say, okay, something happened 25 years ago, and now I am gonna go after them.
Because that happened 25 years ago.
That's
not fair, because like right now people destroy families, and it's not about the person only. They have wives, they have kids, they have
kids
all over the TV. How do they live after that? Oh my God, everyone is bitching, everyone is talking about it. So after so many years, when I was younger, I did so many stupid things.
Maybe I even touched somebody,
or maybe I played with someone, or maybe I did some things. Now I'm a completely different person. I grew to someone amazing or not. It doesn't matter, but you do progress. And I don't believe we should just go on TV and say stuff, I was abused so many years ago. This is not right. If I want to say it, it shouldn't be public. It shouldn't be public until they go through the entire process of trial or whatever. They have all documents. Or yes, this guy is a predator. 100%.
And see, it might be some.
They cannot just accuse people. Once they accuse so many stars, so many people, it's like their lives is destroyed. This is not fair. So I don't believe it's like.
Let's go some light topic, huh?
Remember, guys, you still have to.
But we agree on everything.
Yes, that's actually good. We have to be careful with the microphone because I see that we have a lot of messages that it's breaking up. So I don't know what's going on.
I think it's the internet, and there is nothing we can do about it. But it's also live and record, so be upload as the one thing, so people can watch the whole thing.
Ever actually started when I started traveling on motorcycle. On a motorcycle, traveling to states from west to east coast, from up to north, south, and traveling on a bike is a different experience than traveling and driving in the car. Even I've been into same places. Driving and a motorcycle, and it's a totally different experience. You perceive the world riding a bike to that beautiful, I don't know, stage.
You smell it, you feel it, you
feel the heat, you feel the cold, you wet, the rain, and other stuff. And this is the most. It doesn't matter actually where you go, but the more the beautiful places are, the better it is. This year we're going to Utah with our motorcycle association, the whole club, and Utah is a beautiful state, and I believe that those national parks in Utah are one of the best places on earth.
You will be surprised.
And I heard many people who travel the world, and they saying the Utah scenery is really, really unique, and it's beautiful. And that's where we're going to Utah. I've been to Utah before, but not on a motorcycle, so I'm really excited.
You're going to travel with the whole group, and you're going to see that Monument Valley just before you. Then you're going to see Arches National Park, and then you're going to see
Zion.
You're going to go through Zion National Park.
We're going to be in all the parks, in the Capitol Reeves, Zion, Canyonlands.
Yeah. So we went there with Soku a long time ago. I don't even remember. We took a 1 month vacation at that time. It was the only time.
We cannot afford to take a
month. I don't know how we did this.
Month off work. And actually, since it's Utah, it's kind of far away. So we're doing 12 days, which is still allowed
it's
inside people.
Because
usually with the travel only the like a 9 days from 9 days, 9 days from one weekend to another, but now those two extra days are some
people cannot do it.
Wow, that's a long vacation.
Wow.
Polish mama.
Didn't have many vacations, but I always thought that I wouldn't go to the beach.
Mm-hmm.
And I love the beach. I love the sun. This is the only place when I can sweat. I hate sweating from any other reason. Yes, no, but sweating on the beach, yes, I can fry my body and then go to the water and go back and fry myself more. But I think the best vacation I had, it was before I was married. We bought the boat with my boyfriend at that time, and we spent it wasn't like straight 2 weeks vacations. We went like for the weekends and stuff. It was a Fox Lake right here, Channel Lake, and it was beautiful. It was the people there. We had a barbecue every day. This is what we were living off. Beer, of course, and it wasn't Polish beer. It was you had to be a light beer because you would die in a boat just from one Polish beer. You would just so I tried to learn how to.
Depends who you're talking to.
but frying yourself in the middle of the lake. On an open boat, it was something I loved, and we were water skiing, we were tubing, and it was amazing. And I almost died. I had blisters on my fingers and the hands from holding on to the tube and not falling because I was so tough and I held on to it. It was just I was afraid I was gonna die, literally. But it was so much fun, and I think the group of the people we were, it was. This is the magic, and this is the recipe for a great vacation. Also, me and my husband go together places, and just two of us. Now it's the little one, but going with the right people, I think this is the
this is
that's
very,
big, very
this
important.
Is very good point.
That yeah.
I wanted also say, when you go with a good crowd and good friends who understand each other and have fun with each other, that's the most.
Yeah.
The best part of any vacation.
Yeah, because you, it's
some
not
people,
about
some people like the you know being like just two of them,
yeah.
Romantic getaways or whatever.
But you also can make.
I was always bored.
Yes, I was bored when I was traveling with like my boyfriend at the time. I was bored, and that's why I created the motorcycle club because I said, wait a minute, so many beautiful places, and I want to see this. I was not satisfied just to see by myself. I wanted to see the
other
people.
Wrong boyfriend.
No, it's not about it. That's why he created the group. Because
I know
the group.
I go with Adam, and it's just two of us, and we think, oh, we wanted to have more people, and then we went for our honeymoon. It was just, we woke up and was like, okay, let's go, and we had so much fun, and we didn't sit in a freaking hotel and in suite because we don't do that,
mm-hmm.
But we went deep sea fishing where I got freaking sick and puke on everybody, but it was fun. But we don't sit and we barely were on the beach, but we were doing crazy stuff and like going places and trying new stuff. Oyster shots. It was
when I met her.
It was like a noise in my throat, and I still had it. And I had another round, and it was fun. And I can say that I had a life with oyster shots in my. It was okay.
When I met her, no fireplace, no camping, no fishing, no guns, no boats.
Oh.
Now that's all we do. Fireplace, camping, fishing, outdoors, pigs, mosquitoes, and guns.
I will try to have the best time of my vacation every time I go, but actually last year, I think that I never vacationed in my life that much as last year. Seriously. First, my sister came, so I would like to give her the time of her lifetime, and actually I did, because she came with the jet lag and she went back to Poland with the jet lag as well. So we went from Midwest to East Coast to Las Vegas to West, or other way around, but we were constantly traveling 12 days.
Nice.
Wow.
12. she sings so much that she's like, when she's like asking me, hey, what are we gonna do next time? I said like, well, I was making the list last time, now you're doing the list. So it was like everything. And then 5 months later, my best friend came over from Poland with her two little daughters, 7 and 9 years old. So imagine a four personalities, huge, bigger than life, with one car and the one hotel room to the West Coast. It was a road trip from San Francisco to LA and San Diego. And it was a lot of drama, and it was a lot of laughter. But the band we created, it's non-breakable right now. It's just like, as you all mentioned, it's the matter of fact is with whom you travel, not where.
Yes.
But with whom, and what kind of memories you're collecting, and what you know, what things you do, it's completely different. So yeah, I forget. And then I spent a couple days at my family lake house in Connecticut. That was really insane. And yeah, I have those bruises from the holding up. And I remember the one thing that I was so eager to learn how to water ski that I did it, even with a pool muscle. So I have a pool muscle and I still jump to the water and I did it again. And then I came back to Chicago and I was upset about something and I hit my little toe and I broke it. The same leg that I have the pool muscle. It was like, it can happen only to me. So who would choose the question now?
You guys, who's watching the time? Who's watching the time?
Yeah, we still have time.
15 minutes to go. So, and you still have to mention something about yesterday. You did running this today.
Yeah, I have.
And then
today,
you did. You had party last night, and then you went to Wisconsin today. Yes, or yesterday.
You came back
from Friday.
Wisconsin, yeah.
Friday. So you guys need to just talk about it shortly too.
Well, I don't want to pass.
And plus, you do something.
Yeah, I don't want to dwell on the past, even if it was like this morning. Well, I did, and I'm doing it even though without preparation. That is my thing, and I just go to sleep.
Can you just
three tell hours.
Everybody?
Oh my God! I think that everybody knows that it's the Shamrock Shuffle. It was 39 Shamrock Shuffle. It's the season opening run. It's 8 kilometers, 5 miles. It's not that much, but if you're doing it without the preparation, meaning that you didn't do anything during the winter, you just screw, and it's just like and the wind, it's crucial from the lake. It's like a you could have so many layers you could only imagine, and it's still going through the bumps. But the one thing that it's really good, you finish the line and you know you did it, so nobody will take it away from you. I think that's what it is. And Beata, Becha, my soul sister, and Coco Loco, they made me run a few years ago, and my first run was Mad Run, the Warrior Dash, I think.
Yes,
I'm not gonna tell any details about it because it was really fun and a lot of stupid things happened there. But
I remember this photo is in my garage. I printed this photo. It was like you're in mud, guys. It was amazing.
Oh my God, it was really
I'm
funny.
Afraid of the flash eating bacteria.
But you know,
you don't want to sweat.
I will tell you a couple secrets how to avoid that. About the other mud and other stuff, believe me, it's manageable. But you use it that like daily things that you have in your, you know, cosmetic bag.
I put mud on myself.
No, mud is okay as long as there is no bacteria.
But Mary does this. As I'm gonna say again, I don't dwell on the past, I rather look for the future. And it's another question that I would like to know. This is the subject about a dear to your heart and share your thoughts.
Yes.
The breast cancer was always close to my heart. Last year, I got invited to be a part of a wonderful group, Pink Dots, and we did the Avon Walk. Avon Walk, it was very famous. It was happening like, I think, three or five cities across the United States. And it's 39 miles in June sun, 90 degrees. And it's the first day you do the distance of the marathon, the other day is the half marathon. So unfortunately this year Avon stepped back from being a sponsor of it, so there is no Avon Walk this year. And Beata and I, we decided that we still would like to do something, even though there is no Avon Walk, but it's still a lot of people, and even the men suffer from the breast cancer. And actually, I can bet that each one of us heard at least about one person
who either deal with it, was diagnosed or died.
I think there's another one, Susan Komen.
Susan Komen, but it's a tribute.
Oh, okay. Okay, so you are you guys doing a new one?
We do, it's not that we do the new one. We just would like to support the local people and local organization in order to fight breast cancer.
And I know you mentioned that my neighbor might.
It's private information.
Okay.
What we do, it's we choose the local organization. It's called Silver Lining Foundation, and it's actually a foundation that helps people without the insurance. And they have a fabulous three programs. One is for the weeks. The other one is for mammograms, and the third one is to help family members because they suffer as well. And the 50% goes to that organization, and the 50% will go to the private person that doesn't want to be disclosed the name, but it's someone from the local community, leader, a mother, and a very good person. She ran a couple businesses, and you know, when you run the business, small businesses, there is really tough to afford for the insurance. So we would like to help her with the medical bills.
Okay.
And that's what we do first Friday after Easter. It will be April 6th. It's in Schiller Park. I think that everyone knows Allegra Banket and Tony Maciuszek. We still have a couple of seats available, so it will be awesome if the people who are listening to us and watch us would like to come over. And we can guarantee absolutely amazing time. And we have a special performance by the soloist from the National Theatre of Poland. She will be dancing in the skirt that it was 15 women make that. And
oh,
I think
wow.
It's on the Facebook.
Okay.
So,
but you're also gonna have information under your
yes.
page.
Yeah, it will be the information under my page on my wall, and also I send the email to pretty much all in my group. So,
okay.
But thank you for opportunity to share that. So,
okay.
Awesome. But that what you mentioned yesterday, we had a really big party at Soho, and that was actually the fifth. Annual Kultok thing where the Polish, local Polish bands and artists play and sing Kult, Kazi, and other Kazi Nazhivo songs, covers of these songs. And it was really good. And during that thing, we also had fundraising for Lenka, which everybody knows that kid needs our help. And that was part of the party because we at the club really do like helping people or Polish organizations on fundraising.
You already had one for her, and it was beautiful.
We had one, we had another one,
number.
we're gonna have the next one, we're gonna have for our friend who's really sick. It's a sailor, Tarek, who got a heart attack and he cannot work anymore.
So
we're gonna have that party for it.
Okay.
And we have a lot of charities and we run, and we either do it by ourselves, just us as Soto, or we have Polish organizations, charity organizations, who, let's say, use our clubhouse. We give them a place, and they throw the fundraising parties. For
my first fundraiser was there.
Yes.
My first fundraiser was
6 years
ago.
There was a big fundraiser for the
girl in Poland.
Who is still in
yeah.
Poland, and she's a friend of mine through Facebook, and she likes our events and our
seriously.
Events. Still to this day.
I've never, ever met the person who's so grateful.
Yeah, that was a great day. And we would like, that's what, it's part of the question, what's dear to our
yeah.
heart, is that being, having the pleasure, riding on a motorcycle, having the privilege that we are healthy and in good spirit, that we can ride and we can, pursue our hobbies or passions. We want to just share it with some people who can, because they're sick or just whatever
so
reason,
they
need, whatever for whatever reason they cannot, live their dreams.
I mean, I was at the two events, the about me. My weekend was getting away from the city, from the people, actually, though. We went to Wisconsin, spending time with friends, with my daughter, with family. It was beautiful. But I always have something at the back of my head, and I'm thinking what I'm gonna do this week. I was thinking, oh my God, how this is gonna come out, and I was stressed out. And it was crazy, and it's always crazy with me. And what's dear to my heart is, I was good, I was bad, I was good, I was bad. As everybody, when we're young, we do crazy stuff. We do fun crazy stuff or less fun. And then at some point in your at your life, it's just you think like me. I realized that it's so much hate on Facebook. I cannot stand it. It's just for me, the hate on Facebook just drives me nuts. And I think the main reason why a Polish mama is Polish mama, and I've got this blog that to show people that we can do the same thing actually, and we still can work on our own rules, and we can do what we want and how we want it. The community is so big that everybody can have business, and hating each other, whether it's hating the business or hating somebody on Facebook, it just we're wasting our time, basically.
And energy.
Where we can do something, and Adam is making moves right now because he hates how I talk, and I don't care. I don't care. I just want to say that we need more love and like positive vibes, and you gave me a positive kick in my butt a year ago. I look how I look because of you, because I came here and you were smiling. I came here and I was like, oh my God, she's gonna make me exercise, she's gonna make me jump, this is stupid, I don't wanna be here. And then she started laughing, she started like, what do you say when you you like, punch like people in the face, like, yeah, and it's so much fun. And I walk out of here with great energy, and it motivates me too. She sent me every day a text message, like with motivation and stuff. And maybe sometimes I don't read it, but I see it, and I know it's her, and I know.
And you have another pattern.
And I
have
it enough. And then I have this thing, oh, I'm gonna go live, I'm gonna do this. And people are like, how do you do this? I have a phone in my hand, I have a kid in my hand, and I do all crazy stuff. I have 1,000 phone calls, and I still do things. And people are like, oh, but sometimes you forget things when you do. Of course I forget things. I have so many things on my mind. But I want people to be nicer to each other. That's my goal.
Okay.
That's fabulous.
We're going to wrap up. But before I do, I want to say something about you. Because this whole equipment stuff, you purchased for me. I mean, I gave you the credit card. But but it was like, oh my God. She sent me.
Yes.
I just want to tell all of you that this that we are creating here, it's gonna be for everybody to use. So I want you to know that if you're gonna have your private business or your private passion you wanna talk about, you wanna invite your friends, but you don't wanna invite them to your home, you can invite them here. Here during a day or Saturday, Sunday is always available because I have only classes at night, Monday through Friday. So this whole thing is created for everybody to use for positive stuff. So we're not gonna use this to destroy anybody's life. Like any other life, we want to create something that's going to build everybody up. And for me, when I talk to you, actually, I know Mr. Adam is helping us to do that. I ask Kinga if she can just buy stuff for me, whatever I need, just to create the studio. And she did. And I know it's a lot of work to do that, and then she needs to order this, and then Adam has to set this up. So for the next one, we're gonna be 100% ready. But today, we risk it. This is the first time we're doing this. And for you to come, not knowing what kind of questions I'm gonna ask, is just showing me how much courage you have to do some new stuff. So Marta, Ted, Kinga, Adash, I want to thank you guys for doing this together. This is the first time, and any other another time will be much better than this one. So I am happy to be around people that risk with me stuff. This is the first time it's done it. So, wow.
Thank you. Thank you for your invitation. Yeah. I think that we, the humans are the creatures that we would like to sometimes break the rules and then set up the new example and set up the bars. So
yes.
Thank you for doing it because you are the one one of the person that
I just
all
risk.
The time.
Just stepping out of the circle, I think, makes
the,
you, and then
yeah.
You didn't know, nobody would. Probably thousands of stuff wouldn't be created for us to use if somebody
right.
wouldn't like, hey, maybe this, like, maybe
So yeah, we're gonna speak English the way we speak English. We're gonna invite American people to join us, and then we're gonna talk about immigration, if it's good for America, it's bad. And I wanna tell you, we don't take anybody's job. We create our own jobs. We do stuff that what other people won't do. So. We built this country and we create stuff, so we have to support each other. And then English, yes, there is a lot of clients that won't hire me because they hear I have a different accent, and that's okay. They make me stronger. I go up and get other clients. And those American clients that gave me chance to work with them, I thank you so much. And I think you had always the same thing. Some people,
yeah.
They don't want to deal with people with different accents. They have a right to do it. They have their choice. And then there are people who are willing to do, to they open up like so much for me. They come, like they use us, they wanna get closer to us, they wanna help us. So that's okay too. But what I'm saying is we built this country because we do a lot of hard work. And I think we make this country a better place.
So,
I will agree with that.
So for next time, I think we see you in 4 weeks. We see who's gonna be here. I wanna see if American people can join us. So we're gonna invite a few of you guys. And then also, if anybody wanna come here and do their own show, you are guys welcome. I just have to learn the program and then a few things we have to do to finish up. What you wanna do at the end, we wanna say goodbye and then
and maybe I have an idea. I am just really popping in my head right now. For next time, maybe we can have some public, some audience.
Yes.
And cheering.
Yes. That would be great.
Just
yes.
The,
that we can invite people sitting there, like on the mattress, yoga mat.
We ask them to work out.
Yeah, they just gonna be like, either yes or whoa.
Yeah.
Or the opinion.
Thumbs up.
Yes. Guys.
Let's make something
okay.
Cool and crazy. Let's
yeah,
do something.
Yeah.
Good idea. Yes.
Woohoo!
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Bye. We need live audience.
Yes.
Yes, guys.